Last week, we learned about restitution. And not only that, we talk about the definition of restitution, we also talk about the various time by which restitution can be done, and also the blessing of the restitution. So this morning, we will be talking about importance of restitution. So can we take our Bible out? Exodus 22, 1 to 13. But the essence of Sunday school is the Bible reading and the memory verse. Exodus 22, 1 to 13. Are we all there? Can we give my friend the Bible, please? Please, everybody have your seats. Exodus 22, 1 to 13. Can I have 25 minutes, please? Bible says, if a man steal an ox or a sheep and slaughter it or sell it, he shall restore 5 oxen for an ox and 4 sheep for a sheep. If the thief is found breaking in and is struck so that he died, there shall be no guilt for his bloodshed. If the sun has risen on, there shall be guilt for his bloodshed. He should make full restitution if he has nothing. Then he shall be sold for his thief. Mark that word. He shall be sold. Verse 4 says, if the thief is certainly found alive in his hand, whether it is an ox or donkey or sheep, he shall restore double. If a man causes a field or a vineyard to be grazed and let loose his animal, and it feeds in another man's field, he shall make restitution from the best of his own field and the best of his own vineyard. Verse 6, if fire breaks out and catches in tongues, so that stark grain, standing grain, or the feed is consumed, he who kindled the fire shall surely make restitution. If a man delivers to his neighbor's money or article to keep, and it is stolen out of the man's house, it is the thief. If the thief is found, he shall pay double. Verse 8, if the thief is not found, then the master of the house shall be brought to the judge to see whether he has put his hand into his neighbor's goat. For any kind of trespass, whether it concern an ox, a donkey, a sheep, or nothing, or clothing, or for any kind of lost things which another claims to be his, the cause of both parties shall come before the judge, and whoever the judge condemns shall pay double to his neighbor. If a man delivers to his neighbor, mark that word now, if a man delivers to his neighbor a donkey and an ox, a sheep, or any animal to keep, and he died, it's ought or driven away, no one sees it. Then an oath of the Lord shall be between them both, that he has not put his hand into his neighbor's good, and the owner of it shall accept that, and he shall not make it go. Verse 12. But if in fact it is stolen from him, he shall make restitution to the owner of it. And the last verse 13. If it is torn to pieces by a beast, then he shall bring it as an evidence, and he shall not make good what was torn. May the Lord bless his word in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Our memory verse is taken from Luke 19 verse 8. Let me have your mommy's phone, please. Luke 19, verse 8. Are we there? Luke 19, verse 8.
Yes, sir.
So, want to go.
Zacchaeus too.
Want to go? And Zacchaeus too. And said unto the Lord, Behold, Lord, the half of my good I give to the poor. And if I have taken anything from any man by false accusation, I will restore him fourfold. That is what God is expecting from us. Whatever it is that has not been of the law, we should make sure that we restore whatever we have taken away and restore them with a good faith and with the way the Lord has put it. My dear brother and sister, this morning we are learning about the importance of restitution. We learned last week that restitution is you restoring what you have done through mistakes in the past. You restore your past. That is it. Something you have done out of ignorance, even something that you have done with your eyes open. Something you have done out of your conscience or with your conscience. Something that you have done agree with other people. Now you have come back to the other side of Christ Jesus. Bible says that God is holy and nothing that is unholy cannot come near him. So in order for us to be able to journey with this Christ for a longer time, as Bible says that eternity will spend in heaven, and also some people will also spend eternity in hell, because Bible says after death, judgment comes. And as we read this morning, that whoever the judge condemned is the one that is liable to pay for the double. So this morning, we have two outlines. The first one is, why do we make restitution, and the example in the Bible. The first outline, why do we make restitution? Why do we have to make restitution? It's important. Also, some specific restitution to make. You know, restitution have grace. Yes, they have grace. That's why some people say that you apply wisdom. That's why we have been encouraged last week that before you make any restitution, you allow your pastor to know about it, your spiritual leader. Before I will make any restitution, maybe I've lied to my in-law and my wife didn't know. Now my wife has gotten to know about it. I must let my wife know that I lied to your father. I want to go and make restitution. She will not be the one saying, okay, don't worry. I know my father. This is the way he behaved. This is the way we will go at this point, or talk to somebody or somebody will help us to talk to him, and then he will now call us, and then we'll now ask for forgiveness. That's all. Forgiveness and restitution is not for you to go and argue whether it is right or not. No, 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 no. So the first outline, why do we make restitution? Why do we make restitution? Can we read Leviticus 6:1-5? Somebody there, another person, Acts 24:16. Another person, which one are you reading, man?
Leviticus 6:1-5.
Okay.
And the Lord spake unto Moses. Sorry, sir. Let me just open
it. We don't have the time for that. Please, another person.
Somebody else opened the Bible for him. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, If a soul sin and commit a trespass against the Lord, and lie unto his neighbor in that which was delivered him to keep, or in fellowship, or in a thing taken away by his violence, or has deceived his neighbor, or have found that which was lost and lied concerning it, or sweareth falsely, or in any of all these that a man doeth sinning therein, then it shall be, because he had sinned and is guilty, that he shall restore that which he took violently away, or the things which he had deceitfully gotten, or that which was delivered
unto him
to keep, or the lost things.
Hallelujah.
That was
Amen.
Before.
Amen. Yeah, it's okay. We are just out here that God commanded it.
The
the last part talks about putting a principle on it.
Okay. So God commanded it, so it's an important that we do that. Then anybody ask 24:16?
Acts
24:16.
Yep. It says this.
Can you please raise your volume, please?
It's a few boys glass.
Okay.
That's better. It says in verse 16, it says, this being so, I myself also strive to have a conscience
of yes.
offense towards God and man. Amen. Go on.
That's all. Because we need to do this restitution because we need to clear our conscience before God and before all men. It is important. I want to let you know that if I've done something evil to you and I'm still standing talking to you as a friend, I am worst enemy to you. That is why people always encourage during the marriage counseling that don't always feel for your wife. Don't always feel for your husband. Show it. When you came in this morning, God said, look, you look wonderful. And you said, my daughter also have said it. My wife has made me to look smart. That is it. But some of us, in order for us to clear our conscience, we enter into troubled waters. Some people are passing through maybe loss of friends, loss of monies, issues of life. And we are telling them, look at the way your hair is looking like. It doesn't have to look, it's not even looking, thinking about the hair. He has lost something more valuable than his life. So that kind of way, you are not clearing your conscience, you are even injuring another person's conscience. So you need to do something that it must be within the conscience of God and God's love. That's it. And the third one is, it is the evidence of our conversion which shows our readiness to obey the scripture. That's the reason why we have to do restitution. Because the scripture says it, we must abide with it. So how important is this restitution? Because God commanded it. Second, we have to do it so that we can clear our conscience. Jesus Christ told that woman that was caught in the act of adultery in the Gospel of John. He said, I have nothing against you. Where are your accusers? Some of us, there is no more accusers around us. Our conscience is still telling us you need to repair your life when your life has been repaired by God. I pray in the context of these teachings this morning, the importance of this institution will lift your spiritual souls, body and spirit, to the point where you'll be free with man and free with God in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And some specific restitution to make. We are told here that we should return things that we have stolen, pig, converted to our own use, but which belongs to other person or to our place of work. This includes our tithe, our first fruits, the non payment of your tithe, non payment of your vows, and everything. These are the specific things you have to. And that's why I don't make vows. Some people, they are fond of it. Now, this time around, we want to raise an offering, a seed offering to build the church. And you know you can afford it, but you don't come with your wallet. You are not there with your bank details. And you say, okay, I'll come and give you tomorrow and next week £100. It's possible for you to forget it. And as long as you are holding on of not paying that vow, you need to restitute it. I don't make vow. And I don't allow people to just talk me into things that would destabilize my conscience. I don't do it. And I don't look at what people give before I do anything I give. So that's is very, very specific. And also, please, dig deep. Please, will it be enough that having spent 80, 85 years on this world, and we now find ourselves at the gate of heaven by the grace of God. And the angel there said, excuse me, sir, just hold on. There is something that is covered here. You know, there are some things that they said coded. You know, you are reading some books, but that night they just coded, like television. They are showing you something that happened, but they cover the person's face with something black. Or especially when they have to show the body, they cover the private part. Are you getting me? So, but you will know that this is a woman, this is a man, but you can't specifically know the person. Now, the same thing, what will it be if after you get to heaven, 85 years, and they say, please, you have been clear from hell, but this is not the way to heaven. But excuse me, sir, we have something that Holy Spirit has covered. And I said, Holy Spirit, sir, now came. He just removed it. And the angel read it. Say, excuse me, Pastor Leia, they call you on heart. You took a juice from children's vomit, and you forgot to return it. For this reason, you have a query. 85 years. A bottle, just a packet of juice, just one. That kid's juice. If you remember today, go back to the children's department now, before your 85 years expired. Go back to the children's department now. It's important, it's specific. And say, I'm sorry. It won't kill you. You can buy it. You can buy a packet today. But first of all, tell them, I'm sorry. I stole this thing. So please, when I'm coming, I will bring 2 cartons next week. It's a gift. But for you to have been able to let them know what has happened, you have defeated the kingdom of devil. It's specific. The second one is, we should replace things we have destroyed which belong to others. You see, some people are, how would I call it? They don't have conscience. But this morning we are talking about clear conscience between God and man. If I borrow your car, and in the course of driving, I ran into a ditch, and I realized that the steering or something is not the way I took it, I should be able to come back to you and tell you, hi, Handy, sorry, I took my sister's car the last time. I ran into a ditch, and I find that we need to check the steering. Please, when is it going to be free? Because I know that most of us, we need our car for our daily life here in this country. When is it going to be free? I should be able to take it and take it to that place. Or when is it due for another MOT? I should be able to also be able to do that. And saying the truth, restitution is about bringing what people could not see onto reality so that God can be glorified. These are specific and these are required. Another one we are asked to do is, we should also reconcile with people who we quarrel with in the past. This is a must. Bible says that nobody, nothing, except love. Let me tell you the truth. If I have an issue with you, you are not my God, and you are not up to my God. You are not yet a king that I could not approach. Even kings of the world, people approach them. So how much more that I will now wait until God now reveal, or Holy Spirit reveal unto me, and says that your prayers are being hindered because Handy has an issue with you. No! You can have an issue with me, but it is expected of me not to have an issue with any man except love. That's a gray area. Where is the area do we learn? Where is the area do we put in order for us to know each other? Where is the area that I've tried all, this person does not change? What should I? Brother Faith preached on that on Thursday. If you want to know much about that, please go and check our midweek service on Thursday. And I pray that you'll be blessed in the name of Jesus Christ. Another thing is, we should make restitution to all lies and things wrong said about someone and which have affected the person or presently causing trouble. Let me tell you the truth. There is no way you will walk in life, listen to me this morning, that you will not wrong somebody. There is no way you will walk in life that you will not even wrong yourself. I was bathing this morning. I never realized that the soap was still under the sponge. I was just still trying to clean up the sponge. And I realized that the more I tried to scrub, the more the soap. So I told myself, what is going on? Until when I removed the sponge, I said, wow, you soap, you are here again. I wronged myself. If issue comes up like that, forget about what people say. Stay with God. I've lied. I'm sorry, please. I had an issue with one of my friends that we could not understand ourselves. My youthful friend. And we met. I tried, called, he could not, but eventually we met in somebody's bedding. Not that I could not greet him, but I can't hide it. I can't fake it. Restitution is clear, it's conscience. So I told people around me, he greeted them. I said, okay, no problem. I had an issue with this, my friend. He said, it can't be. I said, it is. It has been. Not a year, it's 3 years ago. I went back to him. And I said, I'm sorry. Please forgive me. I'm sorry. I mean, the guy said, he didn't offend me. We both offended. I said, no, I offended you more. Where I stood is not the same place where you are. If I died 3 years ago, I won't make heaven. But thank God that I pray for this today to come. I never think I will meet you here. And we hug ourselves. And my conscience is clear. The only thing the person said that, look, Leah, we need to talk. We need to sit. It's not a thing. I need to sit with you, your wife. It is you and your wife that actually made me. We are both together. And I said, okay, but I'm not going to force myself out of time that I don't have. And I said, okay, now let's rush this. No, 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 no. I have done what is expected. Now, if I see him now, I'm meeting a friend. I'm meeting a brother. I'm not meeting somebody that I have an anger with. I didn't lie with him, and I didn't lie to him. Likewise, sometime in the house, your wife will be doing something that is not clear to you. Don't just nag. Wait until reason comes. And if things are not clear, please go back. Don't just take an issue the way it is out of men. And I pray the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. And the last one, talking about the specific restitution to me. Marriage contracted contrary to the biblical standard should be revisited. Marriage contracted out of church, lawful parental demand should be granted. White people who have married another person's spouse must prayerfully take steps towards restitution. You must. There are so many people today. Your wife you married is your friend's girl fiancé before. You manipulated the two of them. Now, you have married. You have married. You must be able to please say the truth. I married you. Those things that I told you about my friend the other time, it wasn't because I like you. That was why I've done that. Prayerfully. Because if you marry somebody else's wife, you have not married your wife. You know the catastrophe of life? You are doing what you are not trained to do. And the more you go into, you are not a medical doctor, but you end up attending all the medical classes, all the medical conferences. For what? You can't practice it. If you are a laborer, go for a way by which your activities, your skill as a laborer can be enhanced. You can't play more than 5 roles at once. A father, a husband, a pastor, a worker, and also, what else again? A child or parent. These are the key things responsible for your life. If you took it now as a sportman, a football lover, you are going to miss it. So as part of specific investigation, what are those things that you have done in the past? Think about them this morning. And please, try to revert them back according to the conscience and the clear conscience of God and of men. And I pray the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Before I conclude, is there any questions? Is there any questions? If you have any questions to ask, please, you can do that to this particular videos after the service. will surely get back to you. Importance of restitution is God commanded it. It is a thing that the Bible says we should do, being a good Christian. The second thing is that we should do it to clear our conscience before God and before men. Jesus Christ said it. He said, "The prince of this world has come unto me, and they have nothing. They find nothing in me." So please clear your conscience. And like I said, Jesus Christ said, "Whoever the Son of Man set free is indeed free." But please, sir, set yourself free before the Son of Man set you free. And I pray you will not be found guilty in any way of life in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Any observations, any comments, any feedback, we'll get back to you in the course of these videos. And I pray that today, irrespective of how hard or how bad it has been, please discuss everything you need to restitute with your pastor or your spiritual leader. Look for godly counsel before you proceed. And he that sit on the throne and laugh will laugh concerning you and will rejoice concerning your life. God bless you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In conclusion, do you have any restitution to make? Pray to God for help and take the right step. Holy Spirit is the best friend. Holy Spirit is the best confidant that you should share this word with, and it will help you. And the only thing I will say from my own side is this: be bold. Find God, be bold. Bible says those that know their God, they will be strong and do exploit. Be bold. Choose, look at the two opinions, choose God. Men will not be the one that will judge you, but God is the one that will judge you. David said, "Let me fall into your hand," and David got saved. Please, this morning, irrespective of the restitution we need to make in our home, to our children, to our pastors, to our offices, to our friends, ask the Holy Spirit to help you. And I pray the Lord will help you in the name of Jesus Christ. Can we rise? Maybe you are here. You want God to strengthen you, to help you. You want God to increase the power of the Holy Spirit. Can we please rise, please? I want you to just please ask God this morning. Say, "Father." Say, "Father,
Father,
in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
give me the grace, O Lord,
give me the grace, O Lord,
to be able to repair everything I've done in the past wrongly, so that I can restore my way to please you, to please you." Can you pray on that in the name of Jesus Christ? Can you pray on that? Lord, give me the grace, O Lord, for me to be able to restitute a worthy restitution, an acceptable restitution, the one that will make heaven, O Lord, to be glad concerning my life. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Eternal Father, we thank you. Today we have heard the importance of restitution. As we go into the main service, Lord King of all glory, quicken our mortal being and body and soul, O Lord, to be able to hack into this and for us to be able to do proper restitution in the name of Jesus Christ. Any area where delay, disappointment, or limitation have been the one that has already stopped us, my Father, my Lord, you that send the bigger angel to deliver the message of Daniel back to him, Lord, deliver everything that needed to be done in the right time to us in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
God bless you as we move to the bigger hall. Amen. Amen.